praise our sin and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways. Encourage one another. Agree with one another. Live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Children learn to love the Holy Trinity before they can read
mystery of the Holy Trinity challenges the greatest minds on the planet. St. Augustine pondered the mystery of the Holy Trinity. He preached about it. He wrote about it. He is widely considered to be the smartest person of the first millennium. One day he was walking along the beach contemplating the mystery of the Holy Trinity, and he came across a young boy with a shovel in one hand and a pail in the other, and the little boy had dug out a hole in the sand and was going back and forth from the ocean with the pail full of water, pouring the water into the hole time and time and time again. Finally, St. Augustine asked the lad, "What are you doing?" And the little boy responded, "I am putting the ocean into this hole." And with that, St. Augustine scoffed and he said, "You will never succeed in putting that great ocean into your tiny little hole." To which the young man replied, "Nor will you succeed in putting the mystery of the Trinity into your tiny little mind." And with that, the little boy disappeared, for he was an angel sent by God to teach St. Augustine the most important lesson, that we can never fully appreciate God's nature, God's majesty, God's mercy. Nevertheless, we celebrate this Sunday the life that we share in the Holy Trinity by virtue of our baptism. We were baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. We have been drawn into his divine life so that we might be like him, sharing in his identity and his mission, walking with him where he leads in this life, until one day, please God, we might rejoice with him for all eternity. For though we are but poor sinners, God loves the world so much, God loves you and me so much, that he sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might not perish, but that we might have eternal life. This is the God we worship every time we praise his name by making the sign of the cross. This is the God we worship in this sacred place every time the Holy Spirit draws us together for the holy sacrifice of the Mass, the supreme act of worship offered by Christ the High Priest. I was struck by how many of you responded to the question a couple weeks ago, why do you go to church? And I was struck by the very beautiful responses that you gave me. So many people mentioned that they come to church to be instructed by God's holy word, to be nourished by the Holy Eucharist, to receive that gift of peace that the world cannot bring. So many spoke of receiving from the experience of coming to church, receiving that sense of purpose and mission and direction in life. Beautiful, beautiful responses. And yet we know perfectly well that whatever it is that we receive from coming to church, we receive in faith. We receive these wonderful gifts precisely because we worship. And we worship because we are drawn to worship by the Holy Spirit. We offer to God a fitting sacrifice of praise and adoration. And God, in his goodness, responds to those who offer fitting worship with a clean and upright heart. Graces beyond measure does he give us, including all of the things that we mentioned, peace, sense of well-being, mission, purpose, direction, all of those good things we receive from God, who gives them to us in response to what we give. We come to church not to receive, but to give God our gratitude and our thanks for the blessings that we have received, to give God our sorrow for our sins, to give God our worship, our praise, our adoration, specifically by uniting ourselves with the great sacrifice by being present at the foot of the cross. We give to God our prayers and our petitions, humbly laying them at the foot of the cross, begging him to have mercy on our pleas. We give because we are prompted to give by the Holy Spirit. God the Father receives our worship through Christ Jesus, his Son, our great High Priest. And in response, God does not leave us disappointed, for God will never, ever be outdone in generosity. Praise be to the Holy Trinity, the divine communion of perfect love through which we find the great gifts of faith, hope, and charity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That the Church may continue her mission of evangelization, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our world leaders will shape a society that is just, compassionate, and respectful of all human life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may recognize our baptismal calling to participate in the life-giving mission of the Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For a generous increase of vacations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, that we welcome the transforming love of God in this Holy Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For that they may experience the love of the Holy Trinity in heaven, especially Steve Creech. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, hear us as we humbly bring our needs before you. We trust always in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
And sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of his holy church.
Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day as with one voice they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Servants and your holy people offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us for the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, in all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who those sinners, open your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share of fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us to beseech you into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. house prayer. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.